Hi students, this is S. Srinivas, lecturer in physics, Vignan Junior College, Vadimudi. Students, we started magnetism and matter lesson. Already we completed one video. We introduced the contents of magnetism and matter and explained the weightage. We discussed the basic concepts. What is meant by magnetism and how magnetic materials are existing, what is meant by magnetic field, what is a bar magnet and magnetic movement of bar magnet and calculation of magnetic movement in different cases was discussed in previous video. Students, in this session we continue the discussion of magnetism and matter lesson. Students, in this magnetism and matter chapter, in present video, in this session of discussion, we are going to talk about the following contents. First one is Coulomb's law in magnetism. Already we know about the Coulomb's law in electrostatics. The force of attraction or repulsion between charges were explained in Coulomb's law of electrostatics. Similarly, the force of interaction between magnetic poles will be discussed in the first concept, Coulomb's law in magnetism. Second one is magnetic field due to a magnetic dipole. Generally, any bar magnet, a permanent magnet, always exists in form of magnetic dipole. We discussed already in previous video. And then in this video, we will find the magnetic field due to dipole along different axes. That is the second part. And third content is, if any bar magnet is placed in uniform magnetic field, work required to rotate the magnet from one position to another position. So work required to rotate the magnet as well as torque acting on a bar magnet in uniform magnetic field. And fourth one, when a bar magnet is placed in uniform magnetic field and it slightly displaced from its equilibrium position and released, it may oscillate, it may vibrate to and fro about its mean position. Then what is the time period of vibration of a magnet will be discussed in the fourth content. So these are the contents that we continue of our discussion in magnetism and matter. So comes to first topic, that is Coulomb's law in magnetism. Student, as you are observing in this animation here, in case of magnetic poles, let this be the south pole of one magnet and north pole of another magnet. South and north poles are attract each other. There is attraction force between unlike poles of a magnet, as well as there is a repulsion between like poles. In this animation which I am showing, you clearly observe north and north pole repel, as well as south and south pole repels each other. There is a force of attraction between unlike poles and poles of repulsion between like poles of a magnet. That force value will be given in the Coulomb's law of the magnetism. So Coulomb's law in magnetism, the force of attraction, of course, that is between unlike poles, or force of repulsion, of course, that is between like poles. The force of attraction here or repulsion between two magnetic poles, that is between north and south, or north north or south south, three possible ways are there. The force of attraction and repulsion between two magnetic poles is directly proportional. Here it is directly proportional. Here students, the directly proportional, this is the important point, directly proportional to the product of the pole strengths and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So to understand this statement, let us consider a diagram here. In this animated explanation, you clearly observe it. Let us consider two magnetic poles as shown in the diagram. Here you observe two magnetic poles of pole strengths M1 and M2. So pole strength of this magnetic pole is M1. Look into this diagram. And pole strength of second magnetic pole is M2, and they are separated by distance r. This blue arrow mark line shows the distance of separation between magnetic poles. Let small r be the distance of separation between magnetic poles. Then the force of interaction between the two magnetic poles is given in Coulomb's law of magnetism. If they are like poles, they repel each other. If they are unlike poles, they attract each other. And you know that force is directly proportional to product, directly proportional to product of their pole strengths. So here I write that expression. So force directly proportional to force between magnetic poles is directly proportional to product of their pole strength. So equation is F proportional to M1 M2, and that force is inversely proportional to, see the second part of the statement, inversely proportional to square of the distance. So square of the distance, r is the distance, square of the distance is r square, inversely proportional to square of the distance means F proportional to 1 by r square. By arranging these two in one equation, here we write that F proportional to M1 into M2 divided by r square. The force is directly proportional to product of the pole strengths and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So F proportional to M1 M2 by r square. Here I introduced a proportionality constant so that F becomes, F is equal to K into M1 M2 divided by r square by introducing a proportionality constant in this equation. The K value now, here F is equal to, I replaced K value, this is the K value, in place of K I use mu naught by 4 pi. Mu naught by 4 pi is the proportionality constant in Coulomb's law of magnetism. We know mu naught by 4 pi is equal to 10 power minus 7 SI units. Mu naught by 4 pi 10 power minus 7, or mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 SI units, where mu naught is a permeability of free space. Hence, students, this is the final expression in equation form of Coulomb's law of magnetism. F is equal to the force between magnetic poles given by Coulomb's law of magnetism. The equation form of Coulomb's law of magnetism is F is equal to mu naught by 4 pi M1 M2 by r square. Remember this formula, this is the ultimate result of this explanation. Here, the in vector form, this force is along the line joining the two magnets. So if you consider a unit vector along the line joining as r cap, in vector form we write F bar is equal to mu naught M1 M2 by 4 pi r square into r cap. R cap is a unit vector along the line joining the two magnetic poles. Of course, r cap is equal to r bar by magnitude of r bar. So unit vector, vector by its magnitude. So r bar by magnitude of r. So when we replace r cap by r bar by r, it becomes mu naught M1 M2 r bar by 4 pi r cube. So these two expressions at the bottom of the screen shows the vector form of the equation. In magnitude form, this is the expression, students, this is the required expression for the magnetism, Coulomb's law of magnetism. F is equal to mu naught by 4 pi M1 M2 by r square. So we completed the first content of this today's discussion, that is Coulomb's law of magnetism. So comes to next one, magnetic field due to a magnetic dipole. Next one, we are going to write, or we are going to discuss about the magnetic field due to a magnetic pole. Magnetic pole. Here, let us consider a magnetic pole M of pole strength M of a magnet at a distance R. Let us consider a test charge. Here, the test charge at this point, let us consider a test charge. Let us consider a test magnetic pole of pole strength M0. In electrostatics, we consider test charge. Here, let us consider a magnetic dipole, magnetic pole. Consider a test magnetic dipole of a pole strength M0 here. Then, according to known concept, what we discussed
already F is equal to mu naught by 4 pi, that is K into M M naught by R square. If you have a magnetic pole of pole strength M, at a distance are considered another test magnetic pole of pole strength M naught, then force between these two magnetic poles from Coulomb's law is F is equal to K M M naught by R square. Then magnetic field at this point magnetic field is defined as the magnetic force per unit pole strength. I repeat the definition. Magnetic field induction at particular point, or magnetic field strength at a particular point due to given magnetic pole, is the force experienced by unit pole at that point. Force experienced by unit pole at that point. So, this is the force experienced by M naught pole strength. Then force experienced by unit pole strength is F by M naught. That is equal to Km divided by R square. So that we get B is equal to, I write this expression, due to pole magnetic pole of pole strength M at a distance R, magnetic field strength. Magnetic field strength is given by B is equal to Km divided by R square. Of course, K is mu naught by 4 pi. In free space, the proportionality constant is mu naught by 4 pi into M by R square. We know that mu naught by 4 pi is 10 power minus 7 SI units. And the SI unit of magnetic field, already we know about the SI units in moving charges and magnetism. It is Tesla or Weber per meter square. Here, this direction is very important, students. Here, this part of discussion is also very, very important. We write the magnitude value already. Now, I want to talk about the what is the direction of B bar. If this magnetic pole is north pole, here if you use north pole as magnetic pole, here the magnetic field B bar is away, B bar is outwards, away from the north pole direction. So, this first line, here the magnetic pole is away from north pole, that is important point. Okay, understood. If you consider south pole as magnetic pole here, this is the pole strength M, of course, of south pole. The magnetic field here is towards south pole. The reason is, I explain the reason now. Magnetic field is actually defined as magnetic force experienced by unit north pole placed at this point. This is also another definition. Magnetic field is the force experienced by unit north pole placed at a point. Unit north pole means a north pole obviously repels units north pole. That's why due to north pole, the magnetic field is away from the north pole. Whereas if you use this unit north pole here, south pole obviously attracts it. Therefore, magnetic field due to south pole is towards south pole. This is the explanation. Magnetic field due to south pole at a particular point is towards south pole, whereas magnetic field due to north pole is away from north pole. This is about the directions of the B bar and magnitude of B bar. The magnetic field due to pole strength M is mu naught by 4 pi into M by R square. Student, this is the discussion about magnetic field magnitude and its direction. So, let us move on to the next topic. So, next comes to the one very important topic, that is magnetic field due to a magnetic dipole. So, if you consider any bar magnet always in form of a magnetic dipole. In general, we doesn't have any monopole of a magnet. Magnet, whether it have a long bar magnet or short or very tiny bar magnet, magnet must be in form of magnetic dipole. It has north and south poles, hence it is said to be magnetic dipole. So, we are talk about, we are going to find out the magnetic field, that means B. Already I defined the magnetic field. Magnetic field, that is B, due to a magnetic dipole on two different ways. First one is magnetic dipole at a point on the axial line of magnet. We
we are going to find the magnetic field due to magnetic dipole on axial line of magnet. Axial line means the line joining magnetic poles is axial line.
Line joining magnetic poles is axial line. So let us look into the animated diagram to have this derivation. Here, let this be a bar magnet, which is in form of magnetic dipole. The right side pole of the given magnet is north pole. Left side pole is south pole. Students, look into the animation clearly. Simply, you understand the data with the help of that animation. Here we have a magnet in form of a dipole having a north pole at right side and south pole at left side. Now, discrimination. Let capital M be the magnetic moment.
We will find the expression of a magnetic field in form of magnetic moment, M.
That's why capital M is the magnetic moment of the given bar magnet. And description of magnet. Here, distance between center of magnet and south pole is L, as well as distance between center of magnet and north pole is also L.
So, total length of the magnet is 2L. Length of magnet is said to be 2L.
So that distance from center to north pole is L, as well as center to south pole is also L. And here, this is the axial line. A line joining the poles of magnet, any line joining poles of magnet is axial line. Here, we consider an arbitrary point on axial line and we find out the magnetic field at that point. Let us consider a line along the axial line and let P be an arbitrary point on the axial line of magnet. A line that joining south and north pole is axial line. We extended the axial line and we assume or we consider an arbitrary point P on the axial line. On that point P, at that point P, which lies on the axial line of the magnet, we have to find the magnetic field. That is our aim. Here, for that, let this arbitrary point P on the axial line is at a distance x from center of magnet.
Observe the description. In the animation, I am explaining the description of the derivation.
This arbitrary point P is at a distance x from center of the magnet. Then, here, as I explained already about the direction of magnetic field, due to a magnetic pole, due to north pole of magnet, due to north pole of the given bar magnet at point P, magnetic field is B suffix N, BN, which is directed away from north pole.
That is the nature already explained in previous part of this video. Due to north pole, magnetic field is away from north pole because
magnetic field is the force on unit north pole. Here, when you assume unit north pole, this north pole of magnet must repel unit north pole considered at point P. That's why it is away from north pole.
So, magnetic field due to north pole at point P is let it be BN, which is obviously directed away from north pole.
And similarly, magnetic field due to south pole of the magnet at same point, magnetic field due to south pole of magnet at same point P is towards south pole because unit north pole assumed at point P obviously attracted by the south pole. Therefore, magnetic field due to south pole of magnet at point P is BS, which is directed towards the south pole. The resultant of this BN and BS becomes B on axial line.
Magnetic field at point P is the vector sum of BN and BS.
So, in that way we find the magnetic field. So, as I explained, the magnetic field at point P is BN minus BS. Here, now, let me to write the expressions of BN and BS. So, the general expression for magnetic field is B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into
M by R square. B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into M by R square.
From north pole, distance is x minus L. From north pole, from center, O, P is at a distance x. From north pole, distance of P is x minus L. Then BN is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into m by square of the distance of p from n, that is x minus l, mu naught by 4 pi into m by x minus l whole square. Similarly, magnetic field due to south pole. Here, from center, distance of p is x. From south pole, the distance becomes x plus l. We have to add l. This l is also added to have the distance from p and s. Distance between s and p is x plus l. This total length is x plus l. So, magnetic field which is at point p towards south pole and its strength is mu naught by 4 pi into m by x plus l whole square, x plus l whole square. The resultant is Bn minus Bs. So, magnetic field on axial line, let P be the point on the axial line, B suffix P is equal to Bn minus Bs. This is the formula. So, here mu naught by 4 pi common, m is also common, mu naught by 4 pi into m into here 1 by x minus l whole square minus 1 by x plus l whole square. Here I extend the derivation here. At the bottom of this diagram, I continue the derivation. So, mu naught into m divided by 4 pi into, let us observe the calculation, students. Here, take x minus l whole square into x plus l whole square, LCM in denominator. Then in numerator, we have x plus l whole square minus x minus l whole square. A plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square is 4ab. So, in numerator, the value is 4ab means 4xl. In denominator, this is a minus b into a minus b. This is a plus b into a plus b. That is a square minus b square whole square. I repeat, x minus l whole square means it is in the form of a minus b into a minus b. Second one is in the form of a plus b into a plus b. So, product of these four terms is a square minus b square whole square. Therefore, this is x square minus l square whole square. Here, we have to express magnetic field at point P in terms of magnetic moment. The expression for magnetic moment is product of pole strength and length of magnet, small m into 2L. The expression for magnetic moment is product of small m into 2L. So, split the numerator as m into mu naught by 4 pi into, in numerator we rearrange the expressions, 4XL can be rearranged as 2L into 2X. 2L into 2X equivalent to 4XL divided by x square minus l square whole square. Replace this m into 2L, product of pole strength and length of the magnet, by magnetic moment, so that magnetic field at point P becomes mu naught by 4 pi. Therefore, this is equal to, here I am writing the ultimate expression, magnetic field at point P is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 into capital M. Now I replace the product of pole strength and length of the magnet by capital M, 2M into X whole divided by X square minus L square whole square. This is the expression. Okay, this is the derivation to find out the magnetic field due to a dipole or bar magnet and axial line point. So, this is the expression. After the completion of that derivation, we got this expression. Magnetic field to dipole at any point on the axial line is mu naught by 4 pi into 2m into x by x square minus l square whole square. Terms are capital M is magnetic moment of bar magnet, okay, which is equal to small m into 2l. X is the distance of arbitrary point P on axial line from center of magnet. From center of magnet, arbitrary point is at a distance x, that is x here. If TL is the length of the magnet, then we use L here. Then magnetic field at point P. The direction is here. BN is obviously greater than BS because BN in place of BN in denominator X minus L, in place of BP in denominator BN, BS denominator X plus L. So BN is more in magnitude than BS. So BN minus BS means resultant is in the direction of BN. So it is away from North Pole. Away from North Pole means along the direction of the magnetic moment. Away from North Pole, so resultant value is along this direction, which is also direction of magnetic moment. We know that the magnetic moment is from south to North Pole of magnet. Students, this direction is most important to solve the problems. We must apply this direction to know the correct answers in the problems. So magnetic field on axial line is away from North Pole, so that it is always along the direction of magnetic moment, that is from south to north direction, along the direction of magnetic moment of magnetic dipole. That is the important line. So if you consider a short bar magnet, for short bar magnet, students, if you consider short bar magnet, for short bar magnet, the length of the magnet is very, very less. L is very, very less than the arbitrary point P. L very, very less than X. Then X square minus L square approximately equal to X square, because L is negligible compared to X value. So in denominator, the modification is X square minus L square is approximately equal to X square. So X square whole square. So that here we get under this condition, magnetic field at point P is mu naught into 2mx divided by 4 pi into x square minus L square, as L is negligible in value compared to x. X square minus L square is x square, whole square means x power 4. Cancel x in numerator, so that this is the expression. So magnetic field on axial line due to bar magnet, short bar magnet, is approximately equal to mu naught into 2m by 4 pi x cube. In most of the problems, we use this second equation. We assume a short bar magnet and most of the problems. So, rarely we use the above equation. So, remember these two, but this is very frequently used equation. Where m is the magnetic moment, x is the distance of point P on axial line from center of the magnet, then magnetic field due to short bar magnet on axial line point at a distance x is mu naught into 2m divided by 4 pi x cube. So let us conclude this one with the direction. So magnetic field at a point on the axial line acts along the dipole movement vector, already explained by giving the directions also. So along the magnetic moment, then remember it. So magnetic field on axial line must be along magnetic movement, direction of the magnet, and in magnitude, these are the two expressions. Okay. Next, come to magnetic field due to dipole on equatorial line. So this is the next derivation. Magnetic field due to magnetic dipole. So title is same, but we change the axis. We would like to find out on equatorial line. So second one is, this is the expression. Magnetic field due to magnetic dipole on equatorial line of magnet. Students, now we change the title, we change the position. So once again, consider the bar magnet having north and south poles. We consider the magnet which was discussed in the previous one, same magnet having north and south poles, and O is the center of magnet. As usual, terms are M is the magnetic moment which must directed from south to north pole, and L is the distance between center and south as well as center and north pole, so that length of magnet becomes 2L. And of course, this was the axial line. Already we completed discussion of axial line. Our discussion now extended to equatorial line. So here we would like to find out the equatorial line value. Here this is the title. We would like to find out equatorial line. So at a point on equatorial line of magnet, let us consider what is meant by equatorial line. Students, here this is equatorial line. Once again, look into the animation to understand the equatorial line. So OQ is the equatorial line. Equatorial line is the line passing through center of magnet and perpendicular to length of magnet. Equatorial line is the line passing through center of magnet and perpendicular to length of magnet. So this SM is the length of magnet, perpendicular to length and passing through center. Exactly, this is 90 degrees. This is equatorial line. Consider an arbitrary point Q on the equatorial line. Q be any arbitrary point on the equatorial line. We aimed at the derivation of magnetic field at this point Q on the equatorial line. Distance of this point Q from O is Y now. So in previous case we considered the arbitrary point P an axial line and which was kept at X distance from origin. Now it is Y distance from our center of magnet. So this is equatorial line. Q is the arbitrary point on equatorial line. Its distance is Y. Here we draw two lines joining the north pole and point on equatorial line, joining south pole and point on equatorial line. We draw MQ, a line joining north and equatorial point, SQ, line joining south pole and equatorial point. Then we have to first consider what is magnetic field at point Q due to north pole and magnetic field due to south pole at point Q. So here this angle is theta. These two lines are identical, makes theta angle with this axial line. Here magnetic field due to north pole is always away from north pole in magnitude Bn. And here students, this distance is L. So this distance must be L square plus Y square whole power 1/2. This is hypotenuse, students. This MQ is the hypotenuse of right angle triangle of lengths L and Y. So length of hypotenuse is square root of L square plus Y square. That is L square plus Y square whole power 1/2 is length of MQ. Similarly, Sn also has the same value. This is also same value, square root of L square plus Y square. Same value, because in this right angle triangle SOQ also one side is Y, another side is of length L and hypotenuse is equal. MQ, SQ are equal in length, which is equal to L square plus Y square whole power 1/2. Then magnetic field due to north pole is at point Q is away from north pole, let it be Bn. And magnetic field due to south pole, see the animation, students. Now look into the diagram, we get the direction of magnetic field due to south pole at point Q. So this is the magnetic field at point Q due to south pole, directed towards the south pole. But here one important point is the magnitude of magnetic field due to north pole equal to magnitude of magnetic field due to south pole. Let this value be B. Both are equal magnitude. Because pole strength is same, distance is same. Only reason is pole strength is south pole or north pole, each having pole strength M, small m, as well as distance of the Q from each pole is also same length. That's why magnitude they are equal, but not in direction. Magnitude, magnetic field due to north pole and south pole are equal. Then we have to find resultant. For that, draw the parallelogram. Parallelogram. Here, draw the parallelogram. This is the parallel line to this BS, and this is the parallel line to BN. Then this is the resultant. This is the resultant. Magnetic field at point suffix Q, BQ, this is the resultant. Along with this line, this is the resultant of parallelogram, diagonal of the parallelogram. Diagonal of the parallelogram always gives resultant according to parallelogram law of addition of vectors. So this is the resultant. The resultant, when two vectors are equal in magnitude, the resultant magnetic field BQ is given by the formula 2P cos theta by 2. 2P cos of some angle is pi by 2. 2P cos pi by 2. If two vectors of equivalent magnitude makes an angle pi with each other, then resultant magnitude is given by the formula in parallelogram law of addition of vectors. R is equal to 2P cos of angle pi divided by 2. I write the same formula. So 2 into BN and BS, let it be equal to B, 2B cos of angle. Here this is the external angle to the triangle. External angle theta, theta are the internal angles of the triangle. External angle must be equal to 2 theta. So pi is 2 theta by 2 means theta. 2 theta by 2 means theta. 2B cos theta. Where B is the magnitude of magnetic field at point Q due to either north pole or south pole. Due to either north pole or south pole, magnetic field is given by 2 into mu naught divided by 4 pi. Mu naught divided by 4 pi into m divided by mu naught by 4 pi into m by r square. Expression for magnetic field. Mu naught by 4 pi into m by square of the distance. Square of the distance. L square plus y square whole power 1 by 2 whole square. So it becomes L square plus y square. Square of the distance. So square root get eliminated. Into cos theta. We write the cos theta value. So theta, let us consider ONQ triangle or OSQ triangle. Both are similar. Both are equal. Then cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Cos theta is L by L square plus y square whole power 1 by 2. So cos theta adjacent side is L by adjacent side is L by L square plus y square whole power 1 by 2. So rearranging above equation, here at the bottom I am writing the resultant expression. Mu naught by 4 pi. Observe the rearrangement. Mu naught by 4 pi. M into 2L. In numerator, the remaining terms are M into 2L. Pole strength into length of magnet. Pole strength into length of magnet is magnetic moment. So, mu naught by 4 pi into magnetic moment, that is M. Magnetic moment, M into 2L. By here, L square plus y square whole power 1 into L square plus y square whole power 1 by 2 students. 1 plus 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. So, L square plus y square whole power 1 by 2. This is the expression. So, we write that expression here. Let us look into the expression here. Here, mu naught into mu naught by 4 pi into m divided by y square plus l square whole power 3 by 2. So, what are the terms in this equation? BQ, magnetic field due to magnetic dipole on equatorial line at point Q. On equatorial line at point Q, which is at a distance y from center of the magnet, is BQ. Mu naught by 4 pi constant equal to 10 power minus 7. Capital M is the magnetic moment of given magnetic dipole, that is bar magnet. Capital M magnetic moment, that is small m into 2L. And L is the half of the length of magnet. Y is the distance of this point Q from center of the magnet. Y is the distance of Q from center of the magnet on equatorial line. Then this is the expression. Then this is a magnitude, of course. Then what is the direction? Already we find out the direction. If the bar magnet is like this, then its magnetic moment is from south to north direction. Whereas magnetic field, resultant magnetic field due to magnetic dipole at point Q is along this direction. That is, BQ is along this direction, which is quite opposite to the direction of magnetic moment. Remember, this is the important statement. Magnetic movement due to bar magnet on a point on equatorial line is opposite to the direction of magnetic movement of the given magnet. Opposite to the direction of magnetic movement of given bar magnet. So, this is BQ direction, opposite direction, and it is a magnitude. As usual, if you consider sharp bar magnet, most of the cases we dealt with sharp bar magnets. While solving the problems, we come across with sharp bar magnets. For them, the length of magnet is very, very less than y. Sharp bar magnet itself shows that length is small compared to equatorial distance. So, L is very, very less than y. Then, y square plus L square considered to be L square. Y square plus L square considered to be L square. considered to be y square plus l square, l is negligible value, so y square plus l square considered to be y square, whole power 3 by 2 means y cube, hence this is the expression, mu naught by 4 pi into m by y cube, this is the ultimate expression for sharp bar magnet. Two missed, in axial line we have two in numerator and equatorial line we eliminated two, that is the difference, in that way remember, mu naught by 4 pi into m by y cube. And its direction already explained that this line is most important. Magnetic field at a point on the equatorial line acts opposite to the dipole moment vector of the given bar magnet. For given bar magnet, magnetic moment is from south to north, whereas at equatorial point, the resultant value becomes opposite direction. So ultimately, whatever may be the derivation, rather than the derivation, these two expressions are most important regarding this magnetic field on equatorial line. Mu naught by 4 pi into m by y square plus l square whole power 3 by 2. For sharp bar magnet, it reduces to this form, mu naught by 4 pi into m by y cube. Now we compare the magnetic field due to bar magnet along axial and equatorial line. We completed the derivation, next. Let us compare these two values. I would like to compare. So axial line formula, mu naught by 4 pi into 2m by x cube. For sharp bar magnet, this is axial line value. This is axial line, we know the line value also, we know the magnet and what is meant by axial, everything is known, but just we are recalling, we are summarizing the expression, and axial line is the expression, and of course it is along m bar, along magnetic moment, the summarized points are very important, along m bar direction, whereas magnetic field of the same bar magnet along equatorial line is given by mu naught by 4 pi into m by y cube opposite to m bar. Finally, I am concluding in two lines, ultimate results opposite to m bar direction in this way. And of course, if you consider a magnet, let O be the center of magnet, you consider the equal length R along axial line and equatorial line, let it be R. This is BA of course, and this is BE, which are considered to be axial line and equatorial line respectively at equal distances from center of magnet as shown in the diagram. BA is directed along magnetic moment, whereas BE is directed opposite to the magnetic moment. This is the directions and comparison value here. BA is only for equal distances of sharp bar magnet. For sharp bar magnet, for equal distances points on axial equatorial lines, BA is twice BE, but different opposite in directions, because BA, in BA we have two in numerator. Therefore, 2 times this BQ, so BA is 2BE. This is the, for equal distances, directions are opposite. This is the conclusion. So, let us move on to the next topic, that is torque. So far, we discussed about magnetic field. Let us come to the torque as well as work done. So, first, let me to describe about the torque on a magnetic dipole. Magnetic dipole means here we are using a permanent bar magnet. We considering a permanent bar magnet as a magnetic dipole here. Torque on a magnetic dipole in uniform magnetic field. So, in animation, I describe the data. So, let us see. We get a uniform magnetic field. This representation shows there is uniform magnetic field of magnetic field induction B along the positive x, parallel to positive x axis in a certain region. Now, let us consider a magnet. See, once again, students, look into the diagram. We have a magnet now. Let us consider a bar magnet, that is magnetic dipole. At this right side point, we have north pole. At left side point, we have south pole. North and south poles of the given bar magnet are represented here and here. Of pole strength, small m. Small m is the pole strength. Capital M here. Simultaneously in the magnet, we represented magnetic moment. capital M is the magnetic moment of given bar magnet, small m is the pole strength of each magnet. Such a magnet is kept in uniform magnetic field. Then on north pole the force is along the direction of B bar with strength M B bar. Force acting on north pole is along the direction of B bar with strength M B bar. So this is the strength M B bar and this is the direction. Shows the arrow mark. Force on north pole is along direction of B bar with magnitude M B bar. Force on south pole is opposite direction. Force on south pole is in opposite direction to the B bar direction, because south pole is attracted by the magnetic field. That's why force on south pole is opposite direction of B bar. So see the arrow mark in opposite direction with same magnitude M B bar. These are the two forces. When we analyze the forces acting on the two poles of magnetic dipole, when kept in magnetic field, two forces are acting simultaneously on north and south poles with equal magnitude, opposite direction. So they cancels each other. So the force cancels, is the resultant force is zero. And here direction of, here once again for a clear representation, so I am drawing the, this is the direction of, students look into the diagram, this is the direction of magnetic moment, and blue line shows the magnetic field. Angle between the length of magnet, that is magnetic moment, and the magnetic field is theta. This is theta. Angle between length of magnet and also magnetic moment of magnet and magnetic field is theta. That was represented here, theta. Okay, then length of magnet is 2L, that is Sm value is 2L. Here as we analyzed the two forces acting on north and south poles, they are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction. So the forces of magnitude Mb act in opposite direction on the bar magnet, so they cancels. Hence there is no translational motion of the magnet. This is important. The force experienced by the poles of the magnet doesn't give any resultant force on it, because they are equal. See, Mb and Mb opposite in direction, they simply cancels each other, unable to produce any translational motion. So magnet doesn't gain or doesn't achieve any translational motion in magnetic field because of zero resultant force. Not zero force, zero resultant force. Resultant force together on two poles becomes zero. Hence there is no translatory motion of the magnet in uniform magnetic field. Whereas the two forces are equal and opposite direction, acting at two different points of the magnet, constitute a couple. We know about the couple. If any pair of forces, two equal unlike parallel forces acting at two different points of a body, constitute a couple which produces torque and rotates the magnet. So here we are analyzing, this becomes a couple. Mb bar on north pole, Mb bar force on south pole constitute a couple and produces the torque, and it rotates the magnet. So to find out the torque, this is the expression. Students, torque is the product of magnitude of one force and the perpendicular distance between the two forces. This is perpendicular distance, I mean. So torque is the physical quantity that produces rotatory motion in the object, and the magnitude of torque is equal to, in case of couple, the magnitude of torque produced by the couple is the product of magnitude of one force and perpendicular distance between the two forces. Okay, magnitude of one force is Mb. Perpendicular distance means, if you consider this point as Q, between force at north pole and force at south pole, perpendicular distance is Nq. Clearly you understood this point. Nq is the perpendicular distance. To find Nq in triangle, let us consider triangle SQN. Triangle SQN. In SQN triangle, sin theta, assume sin theta. Sin theta is QN. opposite side. Opposite side is Qn by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is length of magnet, that is 2L.
So, by
2L, adjacent. Okay, in this right angle triangle, sine theta is Qn divided by 2L, and cross multiplying, we find Qn is equal to 2L sine theta. So, replace that perpendicular distance expression here, and force is MB. So, MB into perpendicular distance between these two forces Qn becomes 2L sine theta. We know pretty well, product of pole strength and length of magnet is magnetic moment. So, torque is equal to capital M into B into sine theta, MB sine theta. So, this is the required expression for us. This is the very, very important expression. If a bar magnet of magnetic moment M placed in uniform magnetic field of strength B such that angle between magnetic moment and magnetic field is theta, then torque acts on the bar magnet is MB sin theta. So, you know the terms very well. M is the magnetic moment, B is the magnetic field in the region, theta is the angle between M bar and B bar vectors, then tau is equal to MB sin theta. Then in vector form, it becomes M bar cross B bar in vector form. So, here look into the direction. M bar is magnetic movement direction for the, once again, I am representing the directions here. M bar of the magnet is represented here and B bar by this line, and they are making theta angle. Then M bar cross B bar. M bar cross B bar, cross product is find out by using the right hand thumb rule or screw rule. So, M bar cross B bar shows downward direction. This is the direction of torque. By cross product, we find the value of torque both in magnitude and direction. So, direction of torque is perpendicular to the plane containing M bar and B bar and given by right hand thumb rule. This is about the torque, students. So, I repeat the summarize the final concept. If a bar magnet, as shown in the diagram, of magnetic momentum placed in uniform magnetic field of strength B such that M bar B bar makes theta angle, then torque is given by MB sin theta in magnitude in vector form M bar cross B bar. So, let us come to the work done. With the help of torque, we extend the derivation to find out the work required to move the bar magnet in uniform magnetic field. Once again, see the animation explanation. This is the uniform magnetic field. This representation shows the uniform magnetic field of magnetic induction B. We put a bar magnet at theta 1 angle. Now, we have a bar magnet. See the students, observe the animation. Then you understand it very well. This is the bar magnet that makes theta 1 angle with direction of B bar. Now, torque is acting. Torque always try to rotate the magnet along B bar direction. Torque, intention of torque is, once again, move the magnet along the direction of B bar. Torque try to restore the magnet along B bar. That is the intention and of the torque acting on the bar magnet. Now, theta 1 is the angle made by the bar magnet with B bar. We intentionally, by applying some deflecting torque and rotate the bar magnet, see the animation. So, this is a magnetic force on each one, and it provides the torque for it. And again, as that restoring torque, students, I would like to see the animation once again. Let us observe it. Because of this couple, there was a torque developed on the magnet, and this torque tried to restore the magnet along B bar. Intentionally, by applying torque in opposite direction, that torque applied by us is known as the deflecting torque. We apply a deflecting torque externally on the magnet, and we move the magnet away from the direction of B bar. So, you observed it very clearly in the animation in that way. I displace the magnet. This dotted line shows the initial position of the magnet. The final one shows the final rotated position of the magnet. Now, I rotated the bar magnet in magnetic field from theta 1 angle to theta 2 angle. For this rotation, how much work is done on the magnet. That is our aim. We have to find out the work done on the magnet for this rotation. Again, as the restoring torque by applying deflecting torque. We rotated the magnet from theta 1 to theta 2 angle. Then what is the work done for this rotation? For that, consider one arbitrary position of the magnet. At arbitrary position, let us assume one arbitrary position of magnet. Arbitrary position. At arbitrary position, theta is the angle. Theta 1 is initial angle, theta 2 is final angle. We rotated the magnet from theta 1 to theta 2. Now let us consider one arbitrary position theta at some position, suppose in the magnet, suppose this is the magnetic field, assume a magnet of magnetic moment M, this is the B bar direction, at some angle, some point arbitrary position, it makes theta angle. Now at this theta angle, if I rotate the magnet to very small angle d theta, d theta is the negligible deflection made at theta angle. So d theta, which I represent in the diagram, is very small deflection made by the magnet at theta arbitrary point. Now work done for small deflection is tau d theta. Of course, tau is not constant for theta 1 to theta 2 because torque depends upon theta angle, but at given angle theta is, at given angle theta, let tau be the torque. At that torque, it deflected through small angle. That's why we write tau into d theta. So at theta angle, tau be the torque and magnet be rotated by d theta, then work done for small deflection of the magnet is tau d theta. Here, at theta angle, torque is given by mv sin theta. We know from previous session of our discussion. So, dw, work done is tau d theta for very small angle deflection. At theta angle, tau is mv sin theta d theta. Then total work obtained by using integration. Then all the way, when it rotated from theta 1 to theta angle, the work done is given by, work done is equal to integral mv sin theta, limit changes from theta 1 to theta 2. Mb is constant and integral sin theta d theta. So here Mb is constant. Integral sin theta d theta is minus cos theta. We know that integral sin theta d theta minus cos theta, where theta changes from theta 1 angle to theta 2 angle. Theta changes from theta 1 to theta 2. Substitute the limits. Minus of cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Take minus into the bracket so that work done is mb into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So I summarize the expression. If we have a ball magnet of magnetic moment m placed in uniform magnetic field, initially it makes theta 1 angle. If you rotate the magnet to make theta 2 angle finally, from this rotation of the magnet from theta 1 to theta 2, work done on the magnet, again as the restoring torque, we apply a deflecting torque and rotated the magnet from theta 1 to theta 2 angle. For this rotation, work done is given by mv of cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. Theta 1 initial angle, theta 2 final angle. M magnetic moment of the given bar magnet, B is the magnetic field. Then work done is mv into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So here, if the potential energy is arbitrarily taken 0, then the dipole is at 90 degrees. So at 90 degrees, cos 90 is 0. We know that cos 90 is 0. That's why we assume a reference level as 0 potential energy level. So theta 1 considered to be 90, which is 0. Then potential energy, we consider a reference level to do work from 0 potential energy level. So let theta 1 be 90 degrees. From that position, it is rotated through theta angle. So theta 1 is 90 and theta 2 is theta. Then work done is mb cos 90 minus cos theta. So minus mb cos theta, which is of course in vector dot product form, minus m bar dot b bar, where theta is the angle between m and b. Minus m bar dot b bar,
is the expression for potential energy of a magnet at theta angle. So potential energy can be taken zero arbitrarily at any position, so 90 degrees.
So finally, I summarize this part of discussion. If a bar magnet of magnetic momentum placed in uniform magnetic field of magnetic induction B, then the torque acting on the magnet is MB sin theta, whereas if the magnet is rotated from theta 1 to theta 2 angle, work done is MB of cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. And if any magnet is kept at the theta angle, then potential energy of the magnet in that field is minus MB cos theta.
Minus MB cos theta equal to minus M bar dot B bar. So let us move on to the time period of bar magnet. This is the last topic of our discussion. Time period of magnetic needle in magnetic field. Let this be a rigid support and we suspended a magnet here. We suspended a magnet. Students, once again, this is a rigid support. Here we have a rigid support. From this rigid support, we suspended a wire, a torsionless wire, and we suspended a magnet. In animation, you observe it very clearly. We suspended a magnet from this rigid support by means of a torsionless string, an inextensible string, whose magnetic moment is M, and it is kept in uniform magnetic field. Here, there is uniform magnetic field directed like this, B bar. Here, so to have clear representation, I selected this yellow color. Let this be the uniform magnetic field B bar. In that region, we kept the magnet of magnetic momentum suspended from a wire, as shown in the diagram. Suppose it is displaced. Actually, the magnet is displaced from B bar direction to make theta angle. Understand? Actually, initially we assume magnet is along B bar. Intentionally, we by applying some torque, we displaced the magnet to make theta angle.
If you leave the magnet at theta angle, it can't stay at that position because it is not equilibrium position.
Equilibrium position is always along B bar. If magnet lies along B bar, it is in equilibrium.
Torque is zero. Torque zero, it comes to rest at a position at which torque is zero.
So initially magnet was along B bar. Now we rotated the magnet to make theta angle from the direction of B bar. Then there is a deflecting torque, deflecting, restoring torque. Restoring torque exerts on the magnet and try to move the magnet
along the direction of B bar. This attempt produces oscillations in the magnet. Just look into the diagram how it oscillates. In that way, it continues its oscillations. Once again, you may observe the oscillation, students.
When the bar magnet is displaced from B bar to theta angle and left, leave it, then it produces oscillations as shown in the diagram animation. We have to find out time period of that oscillation. That is our aim. Time period of magnetic needle in magnetic field. That is the important point here. Here, to derive the expression for time period, at theta angle, we know very well, torque acting on the magnet is MB sin theta, but opposite to the direction of theta. It is a restoring torque. Theta is away from the magnetic field, but torque is restoring torque, trying to move the magnet along the direction of B bar. So, tau is equal to minus MB sin theta. But for oscillation, we displace the magnet to very small angle. Theta is very, very small. Therefore, for small angle, sin theta is approximately equal to theta. Therefore, tau, for small angles, tau becomes minus MB theta. For small angles, approximately. And we know that tau is equal to I alpha, torque. Rotatory motion, we have this formula. In mechanics, rotatory motion, we know that tau is equal to I alpha, where I is the moment of inertia of the rotating object, that is bar magnet. Alpha is the angular acceleration. I is moment of inertia, alpha is angular acceleration. Then I alpha is equal to minus mb theta, and cross multiplying we get alpha is equal to minus mb by I into theta.
This is angular acceleration of the magnet in magnetic field.
So at theta angle, magnet gains this angular acceleration
and executes oscillations.
Angular acceleration of angular simple harmonic motion.
Angular acceleration of angular simple harmonic motion is given by,
we know this very well, minus omega square theta. This is for simple harmonic motion.
Angular acceleration of simple harmonic motion, we know that the magnet is making, see the students,
magnet is making that angular simple harmonic motion.
As shown in the animation, you observe it. For that angular simple harmonic motion, angular acceleration is given by minus omega square theta.
In this comparison, we find out omega square is equal to mv divided by I, mv divided by I. Then omega is equal to square root of mb by I. So angular velocity of simple harmonic motion, we get angular velocity of simple harmonic motion is equal to mb by I. Then the time period of simple harmonic motion is 2 pi by omega, time period 2 pi by omega, reciprocal of this one. Therefore time period is 2 pi square root of I by mb. 2 pi square root of I by mb is the expression for time period.
So time period of a bar magnet of magnetic momentum in uniform magnetic field, the I is the moment of inertia of the bar magnet about the given axis of rotation. About this axis is it is rotating, I is the moment of inertia. Then time period is given by 2 pi square root of I by mb. If you suspended any bar magnet in a room, it always comes to rest along the direction of horizontal component of earth magnetic field BH. Most of the cases for naturally suspended magnets, B becomes BH, horizontal component of earth magnetic field BH. So then when you displace the magnet from the rest position, then it starts executing simple harmonic motion. The time period is given by 2 pi square root of I by mbh.
Then for a naturally suspended bar magnet on surface of the earth, the time period is given by I by mbh. Bh is horizontal component of earth magnetic field.
So I summarize this derivation, students, and today's discussion. Here if you have a bar magnet of magnetic momentum suspended in a magnetic field of magnetic induction B, just to displace the magnet by very small angle theta unreleased, due to torque, restoring torque, it starts executing simple harmonic motion. The time period of simple harmonic motion is 2 pi square root of I by mb. So students, in this part of our discussion, we discuss about, in this part of our discussion, we discuss about especially about the bar magnet. First we find out the force of attraction between the magnetic poles, Coulomb's law of magnetism. Followed by it, we define the expression for magnetic field induction, and we calculated magnetic field along axial line and equatorial line of a magnetic dipole, that is bar magnet. Then for a bar magnet, when kept in uniform magnetic field, torque acting on the bar magnet, and then work required to the bar magnet to displace the bar magnet from theta 1 to theta 2 angle, then potential energy of bar magnet, and finally time period of bar magnet. These are the very very important derivations in JE main point of view. Number of questions were given on these concepts which we discussed in today's video. All of the students, thank you for watching. Thank you very much.